In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I speak.
奉主耶稣基督的圣名讲话。
We thank God for giving us this opportunity to learn the scriptures together.
感谢主给我们这机会呢，可以一起来学习神的话语。
I have been assigned to talk about how to explain the Bible.
我被分配要来讲说要如何来解释圣经。
But I guess we need to understand there is a huge difference between teaching a subject in the university from teaching the Word of God.
我们相信呢，就是在大学里面所学习到的跟来教导一个题目，跟我们要来讲解圣经呢是不一样的。
We need to understand that teaching the scriptures is not a science.
我们知道呢，要来讲解圣经呢，不是一个科学。
Teaching the word of God, is, we said, the work of the Holy Spirit.
我们知道要来教导神的话语呢，其实就是圣灵的工作。
And so, in order to teach, we need to be filled by the Holy Spirit.
所以我们要来教导神的话语的时候呢，我们必须要被圣灵来充满。
Because we are talking about matters concerning the Lord God.
因为我们所谈论的呢是有关乎神的事情。
Therefore, we need the presence of the Holy Spirit in our teaching of His Word.
在我们来教导神的话语的时候呢，我们必须需要圣灵的同在。
So when we teach, what are the purposes for teaching the Word of God?
所以当我们来教导神的话语的时候呢，就是教导神的话语的目的是什么？
I want you to first read a verse. Yeah.
我们来看一节经节。
We turn to 2 Corinthians.
请看《以弗后书》。
2 Corinthians, we read chapter 5.
哥林多后书第五章。
We read verse 20. And now then, we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God were pleading through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God.
所以我们做基督的使者，就好像神借我们劝你们一般，我们替基督求你们与神和好。
Paul and his co-workers, are the apostles of Christ.
所以我们知道呢，保罗跟他的同工呢，都是做基督的使者。
They are merely messengers of God to convey, the message or the messages that God want them to convey.
他们都是神的使者呢，他们所做的工作呢，就是要把神要叫他们，神要叫他们把神的信息传给别人。
So in this case, you find that they are to convey the message of reconciliation.
所以这一节我们可以看到呢，他们所要传达的信息呢，就是说与神和好的信息。
So not only Gentiles must be reconciled to God.
所以不是只是指着外邦人要跟神和好。
Even believers of God must be reconciled to God as well.
甚至是神的相信主的人呢，他们也必须要来与神和好。
Many a time we find that God's believers may not live in accordance to God's will.
很多时候我们发现，就是信徒呢，他们可能是没有过着一个符合神旨意的生活。
And therefore, Paul and his co-workers were pleading that the believers be reconciled to God.
所以保罗跟他的同工呢，就在劝勉信徒，他们一定要与神和好。
So you find that the purpose of teaching others, one of the purposes is to help others to reconcile to God, to be reconciled to God.
发现就是来教导他人的其中一个目的呢，就是可以要帮助他们来与神和好。
So when we teach the Bible,
当我们在讲解教导圣经的时候。
So our aim must be clear.
我们的目标一定要很清楚。
We want to help ourselves and others to be reconciled to God.
我们要帮助自己，帮助他人呢，与神和好。
And so that a good relationship is established.
所以这样子的话就可以建立一个良好的关系。
Now we also see that like in the Old Testament time, you know, to talk about the word of God is to impart life to the listeners.
所以我们会发现在旧约的时候呢，当他们来讨论说神的话语的时候呢，就是把这种好的这种信息呢，就是应用在他们的生活里面。
To impart life, yeah, the life of God to others.
要把神的这个神的生命呢，就是传给他们。
So when we talk about the Word of God, we are not talking about human philosophy.
当我们谈论到神的话语的时候呢，我们不是指的说人的这种哲学。
We are not talking about, you know, our own ideas about matters.
我们不是说谈论到我们自己的自对于看待某件事情的自己的想法。
We are talking about matters of God, and we want to impart life to others.
我们谈论的是神的事情呢，就是要把这个生命呢来传给人。
We can see this quite clearly in the book of Deuteronomy.
我们可以在《生命记》里面可以看到。
Now, what I want to do is, please turn to John chapter 6.
我们请翻到约翰福音第六章。
We turn to John chapter 6.
约翰福音第六章
We read verse 68, yes.
第六章六十八节
John chapter 6, verse 68.
约翰福音第六章六十八节
Simon Peter answered him, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life.
人回答说，主啊，你有永生之道，我们还归从谁呢？
We know that the word that Jesus talks about a concern with salvation.
我们知道主耶稣所谈论的道理呢，就是跟救恩是有关系的。
That's why here we are told that the words of Jesus actually are the words of eternal life.
这里怎么说呢？就是指着永生之道。
So when we talk about the Bible.
谈论到圣经的时候
，So we need to understand that you know we need to teach matters concerning salvation.
所以我们要知道，我们所教导的知识要跟救恩是有关系的。
Or our teaching should lead the people to understand what eternal life is.
我们所教导的这些道理呢，就是要来帮助别人来理解到，就是说关于救恩。
Or how to obtain eternal life.
就是教导他们要如何才可以得到永生。
That's why you find that our teaching, yeah, teaching of the Bible in the True Jesus Church is quite different from other Christian denominations.
你会发现在真耶稣教会里面所谈论讲到讲解的圣经跟其他的教派是不一样的。
We find that our message is very focused on eternal life.
我们发现我们的信息都是专注在永生。
We turn to Acts chapter 5.
我们看《使徒行传》第五章。
We turn to Acts of the Apostles chapter 5.
我们请看《使徒行传》第五章。
We read verse 20.
二十节。
Chapter 5, verse 20.
第五章二十节。
Go stand in the temple and speak to the people all the words.Of this life.
说你们去站在殿里，把这生命的道都讲给百姓听。
Judging from chapter 5, it seems that at that time all the apostles were imprisoned.
其实从这第五章来看的话呢，好像当时所有的使徒呢都被下到监里面去。
Here, you know, an angel of the Lord came and opened the prison doors and brought them out.
所以这里主的使者呢也揭开了监门领他们出来。
So and then the apostle were instructed to go and stand in the temple and speak to the people all the words of this life, meaning the gospel of salvation.
所以这里的使徒呢，他们被吩咐要去把生命的道都转给百姓。这个生命的道就是指着就是有关救恩的道理。
Some of us may ask,Does the Bible actually only talk about the gospel of salvation?
有些人会问说，圣经是不是只是谈论到这个救恩的福音呢？
We know that the gospel of salvation is the core.
我们知道就是这个救恩的福音呢，它是这个中心。
All the other messages are connected to this message or messages of salvation.
但是所有其他的信息呢，就是跟这个救恩呢都是连接在一起的。
For example, we are told that we need to love.
比如说，我们被教导说我们要有爱心。
We need to be constantly sanctified.
我们要不断的被洁净。
We understand that all these are connected to salvation.
我们知道这些呢都是跟救恩呢是连接在一起的。
So if we do not have the words of salvation or the gospel of salvation,
如果我们没有这个这个救恩的道理的话，
then we find that our teaching of the Bible will be quite pointless.
这样子我们会发现呢，我们这个教导圣经就成为了没有意义的事情。
So when we teach others or teach the Bible, we actually shine the light of God on ourselves and also on others.
所以当我们来教导圣经的时候呢，我们是把神的光照耀在自己的身上，也照亮在别人的身上。
I want you to read the book of Psalms, chapter 119.
你看诗篇119篇。
The book of Psalms, 119.
诗篇119篇。
We read verse 130. The entrance of your word gives light. It gives understanding to the simple.
你的言语一解开就发出亮光，使愚人通达。
Here we find that, you know, once the word of God is explained, it shall bring forth light.
所以这里我们会发现，当神的话被解释之后呢，被解开之后呢，它就会发出亮光。
And then the simple shall be given understanding.
那些愚人呢，就会通达。
So we need to, like, you know, open up the word of God so that the light of God can shine upon ourselves and others.
所以我们一定要把神的话来解开，使神这个光呢会照亮在我们的身上，同样也会。
And therefore, when we talk about the Bible, we must not just adopt human means to explain the Bible.
所以当我们谈到讲解圣经的时候呢，不要用人的这种意思来去谈论圣经。
So you find that God actually is the main player in teaching the words of God. He must be there to like give understanding to the listeners.
所以我们知道讲解圣经的时候呢，神就是这个主角，他必须要在那里来把这个使人呢可以有这种被开明心窍来理解他的话语。
So in order for our words to be effective,
所以要让我们的话有功效的话。
We must make ourselves worthy to teach.
我们应该让自己配得来教导神的话。
Even though deep down in our heart, we understand that we are not qualified to teach.
尽管在我们内心深处，我们知道说呢，我们是还没有这个资格去来教导。
Since we have been entrusted with the duty to teach,
但是我们已经被托了要来教导他人的这个责任之后。
We therefore must always improve ourselves spiritually.
所以我们一定要就是确保在这个属灵方面上，我们要一直不断的来进步。
So that when we teach the word of God,
所以当我们再来教导神的话语的时候，
we are able to open, you know, like open up the word, and so that the light can shine forth.
是，我们就可以有办法，就是让我们的言语被解开，可以发出亮光。
Like, you know, our words can be understood and cause, you know, the foolish to become wise.
所以是我们的话呢，我们所讲的话呢，被人理解，那愚昧的人可以通达。
So when we talk about teaching the Bible, there are two points that we need to bear in mind.
所以当我们谈论到圣经的时候呢，有两点是我们要注意的。
The first is the speaker himself or the teacher himself.
首先就是讲员跟老师本身。
Second is the word of God.
第二个呢就是神的话。
I want to spend a bit of time to talk about the first point.
我想花点时间来讨论第一点。
So in order to speak the word of God or to teach the word of God, we must first be cultivated.
首先要来讲论，来教导神的话语之前呢，我们自己要来灵修自己。
We need to understand that the word of God is good.
我们要理解到呢，说神的话，神的道是好的。
The word of God is pure.
神的话语是纯洁的。
The word of God is full of power.
神的话是充满能力的。
Now the word of God has to be conveyed through us.
所以神的话呢，要借着我们去传出去。
But we have to make sure that this vessel is good as well.
那首先我们要确保说，这个传达神的话的器皿呢是要好是好的。
We know that good and bad cannot be mixed together.
我们知道好与坏是不可相交的。
If we are not good,
如果我们不好的话。
We find that the good word of the Lord cannot be retained in us.
那么我们会发现神的话呢，就是神的话的好处呢，没有办法存在我们的心中。
Even if we try to explain or to teach the word of God,
尽管我们尝试着要来解释神的话语，教导。
Whatever comes out from our mouth will not be good.
无论任何从我们口中所说出来的话都不是好的。
Because we are not good ourselves.
因为我们自己本身就不是好的。
So in order to teach,
所以我们要来教导的话，
it's not about acquiring a skill, you know, to learn how to analyze the Bible only.
不是说只是要得到就是有这样子可以来分析圣经的这种话语的能力而已。
I don't deny that, you know, analyzing the scriptures to know how to do it is important.
我不是在否认说就是要来有这种分析圣经的这种能力是不好的，它是很重要的。
But it cannot be more important than our spiritual cultivation.
但是呢，这个跟我们的自己个人灵修来说的话呢，是个人灵修更重要。
I want you to read 2 Timothy.
我们看提摩太后书。
We turn to 2 Timothy.
提摩太后书。
Chapter 2.
提摩太后书第二章。
We turn to 2 Timothy chapter 2.
提摩太后书第二章。
This is a reminder, you know, given by Paul to Timothy.
这个是保罗给提摩太的提醒。
And asking Timothy to remind, you know, the believers to bear in mind these important things as listed from verse 14 onwards.
就是要来提醒他要来提醒工人呢，就是这些重要的事情从十四节就可以看到。
Okay, we read from verse 14.
我们读十四节。
Verse 14.
十四节。
Remind them of these things, charging them before the Lord not to strive about words to no profit.To the ruin of the hearers.
你要使众人回想这些事，在主面前嘱咐他们，不可为言语争辩，这是没有益处的，只能败坏听见的人。
Paul, you know, told Timothy to remind the workers not to strive about words.
所以这里的保罗告诉提摩太，要来提醒工人呢，不要为言语做争辩。
You know, sometimes you find that we may not strive about words verbally.
有的时候我们会发现呢，我们不是说在这种口头上的言语来争辩。
But sometimes you find that, you know, it can be a kind of strife within the heart.
有的时候我们会发现这样子的这种争辩纷争呢，是从内心里面有的。
Because we are not pleased with a certain matter.
因为我们可能对有些事情我们是不满意的。
We are not happy with a certain individual.
我们可能对有些人呢是不满意的。
Even though we do not speak ill of the person verbally.
尽管我们在言语上呢没有口头上没有恶言去来抵讲别人。
But our heart actually is like against the person.
但我们的心呢其实是在敌对那个人。
You find that this will cloud our understanding of the word of God.
这样子我们会发现呢，拥有这样的心态会就是模糊了我们对神的话语的理解。
So the first thing that we need to do if we want to teach is to make sure that we don't strive about words.
所以我们如果要来第一件事情，我们要来学会来教导神的话语的话呢，我们要确保说不可以为言语争辩。
If we always argue with one another,
如果我们一直在跟别人来吵架的话，
Here it says, you know, we will ruin the hearers.
这里告诉我们说, 这样子只能败坏, 听见的人。
It's like saying that you will ruin, you know, those whom you are supposed to teach.
这里告诉我们, 其实意思是指着说呢,
so, you know, spiritually speaking, we must be very determined not to sin with our words.
所以其实我们这个, 从属灵角度来说的话呢, 我们必须要就是下定决心, 不要因为我们, 不要在言语上面犯罪。
If we are very loose with our words, and we don't bridle our tongues.
如果我们不遏制我们自己的舌头的话,
on the pulpit, you know, it seems that we are very spiritual, very divine, we teach others.
在这个讲台上面看起来我们好像是非常的, 就是在教导人的,
It seems that we are very spiritual.
看起来我们好像是非常的属灵。
But you know, after we have preached, we find that you know our words are not restrained.
但是我们会发现，就是在我们讲完之后呢，就是我们的话好像是没有被 没有被限制的，没有被。
Do you think we can really teach the word of God well and effectively?
那我们是否说认为这样子我们就可以很好的有 把神的话给教导出去呢？
So you find that if we don't bridle our tongues, then we are actually deceiving ourselves. Okay, we read verse 15. Chapter 2, verse 15. Be diligent to present yourselves approved to God as a worker who does not need to be ashamed. Rightly dividing the word of truth.
神面前得蒙喜悦，做无愧的工人， 按着正义分解真理的道。
There are two parts, to this verse.
背景呢，有两部分。
First, we must be diligent to present ourselves approved to God.
我们第一部分呢，就是我们要竭力在神面前得蒙喜悦。
Meaning that we must not just put up an outward show, you know, wanting people to accept us and to know who we are.
所以意思是说呢，我们不要就是说， 就是为了得讨别人的喜悦， 让他们来接受我们。
What is important is that we must be approved by God.
更重要的是呢，我们必须要被神， 要得讨神的喜悦。
Meaning that we must be inward searching.
意思是说呢，我们要在就是内在的，就是 在审查我们自己。
We all have this a common problem.
我们每个人都会有个共同的问题。
We know how to search others, but we do not know how to search ourselves.
我们很懂得要去如何的来去 去查别人，就是 查别人的问题, 但是却不懂得要来就是去省察我们自己。
In order to speak the word of God, we must first make sure that we are approved by God.
要来讲神的话的话呢, 我们首先要确保说我们是被神所喜悦的工人。
Because we have searched into ourselves.
因为我们有自己就是在内在来就是 反省来省察我们自己。
We have changed ourselves.
我们有改变我们自己。
We have pleaded with the Lord to help us to be better.
我们也有祈求神来帮助我们, 让我们成为更好的人。
And therefore, there is no reason for us to be ashamed.
所以就是根本就没有任何的理由可以让我们成为一个 有愧的人。
Because God has approved us.
因为神呢, 就是已经认同了我们。
Because God has approved us, therefore we can handle the word of God correctly.
因为神已经认同我们的话, 我们就可以有办法的来准确的来 讲解神的话语。
Or you can say that we will also be very careful to handle the word of God.
或者是说我们会非常的小心的来处理神, 来 看待神的话。
Because we want to be approved continuously by God.
因为我们想要的是不断的被神来说, 所认同得他的喜悦。
You know, to handle the word of God correctly or to rightly divide the word of truth also means that, you know, we must point out the direction.
所以就是我们要来认真的来看待神的话语的时候呢，就是意思是说我们要被，就是要被，就是指着，被带领着到一个正确的方向上面。
So when you handle the word of God, it means that you are able to point out the direction that God wants our hearers to follow.
所以就是意思就是说就是神就是想要让我们的听者呢就是可以来正确的来来跟循我们所讲的话语。
This idea actually can be found in the book of Proverbs.
其实这个可以在箴言书上面也可以看到。
We turn to the book of Proverbs, chapter 3.
我们看箴言书第三章。
We read verse 6.
第六节。
Verse 6.
第六节。
In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path.
在你一切所行的事上都要认定他，他必指引你的路。
Or here it says, he shall make or smooth or make straight your path.
这也指着说他必修止你的道路。
You know, the idea is like giving you direction.
其实这个意思就是说呢，给你这个指引你的方向。
So that when you walk on your path, you will not be stumbled.
所以在你一切所行的这种事上道路上呢，你就不会被跌倒。
We also turn to Proverbs chapter 11.
我们请看箴言十一章。
We read verse 5.
箴言十一章第五节。
Proverbs chapter 11 verse 5.
箴言十一章第五节。
The righteousness of the blameless will direct his way aright, but the wicked will fall by his own wickedness.
完全人的义必指引他的路，但恶人必因自己的恶跌倒。
You know, in the English version, the word direct is used.
所以我们知道在英文的版本呢，就是说就是来指引，就
And it means to make smooth or to make straight.
意思就是说呢，就是修直。
Able to give directions, yeah.
就是有办法可以给到这个方向。
So you find that we can only handle the word of God correctly or to give direction to our listeners when we ourselves are not ashamed of the word.When we ourselves are approved before God.
所以就是当我们是作为就是成为一个无愧的工人被神所蒙喜悦的话呢，我们才可以有办法来正确的就是把神的话来传给别人，来可以来指引他们听到的人，这个给他们一个指引，他们正确的方向。
Only that we said that we can teach the word of God effectively by the grace or by the power of the Lord.
我们说呢，有这个神的恩典，神的大能，我们才可以有更有功效的把神的话语给讲出去。
I want you to read back to 2 Timothy.
我们再看回提摩太后书。
2 Timothy, we read chapter 2.
提摩太后书第二章。
Verse 16, yeah.
第十六节。
Chapter 2, verse 16.
第二章十六节。
But shun profane and idle babblings, for they will increase to more ungodliness.
但要远避世俗的虚谈，因为这等人必进到更不敬虔的地步。
Okay, to summarize the verse here, it means that, you know, we must not speak things which are not godly.
所以这集的总结的就是说呢，我们不要谈论一些不敬虔的事情。
So it seems that, you know, in order to handle the word of God to teach effectively our words,You know, in our daily life are important.
所以这里可以看到，就是说要来，就是更加慎重的来，看待处理神的话的时候呢，我们日常生活，我们的言语呢，所说的话呢，都是非常的重要。
You know, sometimes the word that we speak can actually harm our own spiritual life.
有的时候我们会发现，我们所说的话呢，其实会对我们的灵命是会有很大的危害。
It can also ruin, you know, the hearers.
也会败坏听见的人。
It can also bring about ungodliness.
同样的，也会就是带来更多的不敬虔。
Think about this. Yeah? If we are the creator of ungodliness.
我们想象一下，如果我们就是这个不敬虔的这个创造者的话。
Or we ruin the hearers with our words.
或者是说，我们是用因为我们的言语败坏了听见的人的话。
Now, how can we teach the word of God effectively?
那我们要如何的才可以就是更有效的来讲解神教导神的话呢？
So You know, spiritual cultivation in this regard, yeah, meaning to bridle our tongues, is crucially important.
所以这里的属灵的灵修告诉我们呢，就是要来热止我们的舌头呢，是非常的重要。
So that you know our heart is calm and is godly before God.
使我们的心呢，在神的面前呢是平静的，并且也是敬虔的。
I guess we all have this experience before when we have an argument with others.
我相信我们每个人可能都会有这样子的经历，就是跟别人吵架的经历。
It can take many days, you know, before our heart is settled.
可能要花很，就是要花我们很多天的时间呢，才可以让我们平静下来。
If our heart is not peaceful, then how can we teach the word of God effectively?
如果我们的心都不平静的话呢，那么我们如何才可以去更有效的来教导神的话语呢？
We said, how can we convey, you know, the message of life yeah, to our listeners?
我们说呢，叫如何才可以把这个生命之道呢，传给听见的人？
Of course, when we talk about teaching the word of God, we must know the word.
所以当我们谈到教导神的话的时候呢，我们肯定也要理解明白神的话。
And therefore, we have to, you know, constantly search into the word of God.
So, 我们一定要不断的来，更加的来参考神的话语。
I think the idea of searching the word of God has to be explained.
我们知道呢，要来查考神的话，这个想法呢是必须要被来解释的。
Now, what exactly does it mean?
这个意思到底是什么意思呢？
Or you can ask yourself, yeah, How have you, or I ask you a question, how have you been searching the word of God?
我想问大家一个问题是说，你们是如何的来查考神的话语呢？
I think to most of us, it means that we read the Bible.
对我们很多人来说呢，这意思可能就是说读经。
Or we read up some relevant materials.
或者是我们读一些相关的材料。
Materials you know, that are connected to the subject that we are studying.
就是我们所找的这个材料呢，是跟我们来学习的这个这个主题呢是一样的。
And I think to most of us, this is searching the Bible.
对我们很多人来说，这个就是可能就是我们所认为的查考圣经。
All right, or to discuss the word of God amongst ourselves.
或者就是说我们自己当中来讨论，一起来探讨讨论神的话语。
Now, I want you to look at the passage.
我想大家来看一个经节。
We turn to the book of Psalms. The book of Psalms, we read chapter 1.
一篇。
I guess all of us are familiar with this passage, chapter 1.
我相信我们大家对这第一篇呢都是非常的熟悉。
We read chapter 1, verse 2.
我们读第一篇第二节。
But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night.
唯喜爱神的律法，昼夜思想，这人变为有福。
So here, you know, you can see the mindset of the psalmist here.
所以这里我们可以看到诗者的心态。
Here we are told that you know he meditates the word of God or the law of the Lord, yeah, day and night.
所以这里我们可以看到呢，这个诗者他是昼夜来思想神的律法跟话语。
He really loves the law of the Lord.
他是真的喜爱神的律法。
Now the point I'm making here is that you know we need to develop this love for the word of God.
所以我这里想要强调的一点呢，就是说我们必须真的要来建立喜爱神的律法的心。
You know, we teach the word of God. Yeah, sometimes we feel that because we are assigned, you know, to teach, and therefore we have no choice but to read the Bible. Yeah.
有的时候我们就是要来读经的话，其实是因为我们会主要是因为我们被分配到要来去教导神的话，所以我们就是没办法的情况下才去读经。
Because I have to teach RE next week, and therefore I have to read up.
因为我下个星期要宣教，所以我必须要来看圣经， 才可以有办法。
You find that this attitude is not enough, you know, for us. It's not good enough for us to teach the word of God effectively.
所以我们会发现，拥有这样子的心态的话呢，就是根本就没有让我们好好的有办法把神的话更有功效的来教导出去。
So we must develop this love for the word of God.
所以我们必须要来建立这样子对喜爱神的律法的心。
Even when we are not teaching.
尽管我们是没有要去教导。
Or we are not assigned to teach.
或者是说我们没有被分配到要去分。
We must still continue reading the word of God and studying the word of God.
我们还是要不断的来学习来读神的话语。
How can we steadfastly continue studying the word of God?
所以我们要如何才可以就是恒心的来继续的来学习神的话语呢？
We come back to Psalm chapter 1.
我们回到诗篇第一篇。
We read the second part of verse 2.And his law he meditates day and night.
神的律法昼夜思想。
Meaning that he uses the word of God to teach himself.
意思是说呢，他就是用神的律法来教导他自己。
So when a person is taught by the word of God.
所以当一个人呢被神的话语被神的话语教导的时候
，or say when the person is well taught by the word of God，
或者是说一个人他是非常好的被神的话语来教导的时候
，naturally he will develop this love for the truth，
就是他们很自然而然就会就是会有建立了这样子喜爱神的律法的心。
Because a person who is well taught means that he knows the importance of the word。
所以一个人如果是被好好的教导的话呢，意思就是说呢，他们知道就是神的话语的重要性。
This understanding comes from the heart.
因为这样子的那个理解呢，是从心来的。
And therefore, he would always want to study the word and to continue knowing more about the word.
所以他就会来继续的来学习神的话语，来更加要来懂得神更多的话语。
If in our In our daily life, when we are not assigned to teach, you know, if there is this reluctance in us, you know, we don't feel like reading the word, it means that we are not well taught.
所以，如果在我们的日常生活当中，我们没有被分配到要来教做任何的这种教导工作的话，但是我们却很不情愿的来去看神的话语的话，意思是说呢，我们是没有被好好的被教导。
If the word of God has taught us well, or we have allowed the word of God to teach us well, then we will have the love for the word.
因为如果神的话有好好，我们有神的话好好来教导的话呢，或者是我们让神的话来好好的来教导我们，那这样子的话呢，我们就一定会有建立这样子喜爱神的律法的心。
We read the book of Psalms, chapter 119.
我们看诗篇119篇。
We read verse 15.
我们请读十五节。
Psalm 119 verse 15。
诗篇九篇十五节。
Here again, it uses the word meditate.
这里呢，就再次用到了默想。
I will meditate on your precepts and contemplate your ways.
我要默想你的训词，看住你的道路。
Or the English version says, I will look into your ways.
英文版本是说呢，我会查看你的道路。
You find that a person, if he is taught, if he uses the word of God to teach himself,
我们会发现一个人呢，如果是用神的话来自己教导自己的话，
he will always want to look into, you know, the way of God.
他们肯定就是会更加的来看重呢，神的道路。
In all the things that he does, he would make sure that, you know, what he does is right before God's eyes.
他会确保说呢，他的所作所为在神的眼中呢都是对的事情。
Now think about this.
那我们这样想一下。
Like in the church, yeah, we are given many tasks to do.
我们知道在教会里呢，有的时候我们会被分配到了做很多的圣工。
When we do God's work, we do not think about God's way, how it should be done to please the Lord.
但是如果我们做神的圣工的话呢，却没有想到就说神的道路的话，那么我们如何才可以就是更有效的把这个事情给做好呢？
It means that we don't really take the word of God very seriously.
其实这个意思就是说呢，我们是没有好好的来看重神的话语，神的。
How is it that you know in our work for God, we are not able to please Him?
那这样子的话呢，我们在给为神做工的时候呢，我们要如何才可以讨神的喜悦？
So we are not able to please Him because we have not been taught well.
因为我们没有被神的话来好好教导的话，我们要如何才可以来去讨他的喜悦呢？
That's why if we have not been taught well, then obviously we will cause problems in our service to God.
所以这样子也会导致，就是我们在服侍神的圣工，服侍神的方面的话呢，也会造成问题。
Cause problems to ourselves and to the church and to our hearers.
这个问题不只是会给自己，并且给教会，同样会给听见的人来制造出问题来。
So we must allow the word of God to teach us, and so that we will have the love for the word.
所以我们必须要让神的话来教导我们，允许让神的话来教导我们，使我们才可以有这样的喜爱神律法的心。
So that our hearts can be completely changed, transformed.
这样子的话呢，我们心才可以真正的被改变。
We read one more passage.
我们再读一节。
We turn to Acts of the Apostles.
请看使徒行传。
Acts chapter 17.
使徒行传十七章。
We read verse 11.
十七章十一节。
Chapter 17, verse 11.
十七章十一节。
And these were more fair-minded than those in Thessalonica, in that they received the word with all readiness, and searched the scriptures daily to find out whether these things were so.
这地方的人显与帖撒罗尼迦的人甘心领受这道，天天查考圣经，要晓得这道是与不是。
We see that we have received the word of God.
所以我们谈到说呢，我们已经领受到神的话语。
We always listen to His word.
我们也一直在听他的话。
Here we find that those who were in Berea, they wanted to find out more about those words that they have heard.
所以我们会发现呢，这边在这里比尼亚的人呢，他们想要更加的来领受到他们所听已经听到的道理，想要听。
The finding out here is with a good intention.
所以我们这里会发现，他们这个是出于这种好的动机。
To strengthen their faith in the word.
其实就是想要让他们就是在这个道理上面坚固他们自己的信心。
How do we know that they have a good mind?
我们如何晓得呢？他们是有出于这种好的心呢？
If you read verse 11, yeah, and it begins by saying that these were more fair-minded than those in Thessalonica.
这十一节这里告诉我们说，这里地方的人呢，显于帖撒罗尼迦的人。
You know, if you look at the face value of this verse, it means that the believers in Berea are better than those in Thessalonica.
所以从这里我们可以看到呢，其实在皮尼亚的信徒呢，比帖撒罗尼迦的信徒还更好。
Meaning that they have a noble mindset.
意思是指说他们有更这种崇高的这种心态。
They wanted to know what they believe in.
因为他们想要知道他们所信的是什么。
With a good intention.
就是出于好的动机。
To confirm their own faith.
就是要来证明他们的信仰。
To themselves and also before God.
就是要来证明他们在他们自己的面前，还有在神的面前来证明自己的信仰。
By searching into the word.
就是要来查考圣经。
I guess that this is something that we need to bear in mind.
所以这同样也是我们一定要放在心里。
When we search the word of God, particularly when we talk about the gospel of salvation.
当我们谈到查考圣经，特别是谈论到关于救恩的福音，
we need to find out more about what we believe in.
我们一定要花更多的时间来找出我们所相信的是什么。
Because the gospel of salvation that we believe in are connected to the entire scriptures, entire Bible.
因为我们是相信的救恩的福音呢，是跟整个圣经呢是密不可缺的。
So when we search into it, we must search into it with a good mind, a good heart.
所以当我们来谈论到查考圣经的时候呢，我们必须要拥有一个好的心态，好的心。
We want to know more about what we believe in.
我们要就是在我们所信知道的方面上面的话呢，我们想要知道更多。
Some people they search into the scriptures with the will to challenge their belief, their own belief.
所以有些人查考圣经的目的呢，就是要来挑战他们自己所信的。
This is very risky and dangerous.
这是一件非常危险的事情去做。
So if we do that, how can we teach others effectively?
如果我们这样子做的话呢，我们如何才可以更有效的来教导别人呢？
So may God help us.
愿神帮助我们。
We are going to conclude the first session here.
我们第一节就是要在这里结束。